Let's now understand what is the actual cost of a capital asset which is transferred in the process of amalgamation by the amalgamating company to the amalgamated company. Now, what happens in case of amalgamation is that if there are two companies, one company, let's say in this particular video, it's company A, goes and merges into B, and what is left is afterwards is only company B. So company A goes out of existence. And all this happens through a court process wherein both the companies go to the court and file a scheme of amalgamation and say, please merge the business of two companies. Now in this case, what will happen is whatever assets are held by A will also in this process get transferred to B. And thereafter, B would be claiming depreciation on these assets. So the question which arises is, on what value should B claim depreciation? Let's say, again, take an example. There is a building in the books of A, the cost of which for depreciation purposes, 500. So let's say WDV is 500, tax WDV. Where a capital asset, again, it's applicable only to the transfer of a capital asset, is transferred under a court-approved scheme of amalgamation by the amalgamating company. In this case, amalgamating company is company A, the company which goes out of existence, to the amalgamated company, which is company B. Now, please note that in case of amalgamation, it is essential that the amalgamated company or the surviving company should be an Indian company. If this company is not an Indian company, then the benefit or this provision is not applicable. Actual cost shall be taken to be the same as it would have been if the amalgamating company had continued to hold the capital asset for the purpose of its own business. This means that the value of this capital asset will be the same which the amalgamating company would have accounted for in its books of accounts. So, if the amalgamating company, which is company A in our case, had a value of 500 in its books of accounts for this particular asset, the value for B for tax purposes shall also remain at 500. It will not increase or decrease.